music genre was apt, because I must have been smoking some good shit to buy this sight unseen, located over 2,500 km away, and having to take 6 days to get it home. Last episode, the next task is to get this off the trailer with no forklift and get it into my garage. How hard can it be? Very ended up being the answer to that one. Drive itself's a bit of a challenge. It's a tight corner, there's not enough room to put the car and the trailer straight, and it's steeper than it looks. It's probably about 1.5 meters fall in the space of a couple of car lengths. Last episode I did mention a plan for getting this off the trailer. Well, if anybody's ever done T-tray skids, it's this that's given me the idea. So I'll put some trays underneath the wheels, lessen the friction, should make it easier to drag along. And by drag along, I mean take the winch line, put it round the tube bender that's bolted to the floor in the garage, tight to the back of the car, and winch it up. Easy, hey? Not so. You can see the car doesn't move, but the trailer and the four-wheel drive are. Plan two, use the hydraulic jacks. Give it a little bit of a helping hand to start off with. Can't put them on the front wheels though. It won't pass the arches of the trailer, so it's just one trolley jack holding the whole of the front up. But at least we get a little bit of movement. Double teapot pose means I've no fucking idea what to do next. Might have to pull it back as far as it'll go. Trays underneath, but next, drastic actions. But before we do any more, it needs to be as straight as possible. Definitely more straps required at this point. Do some sketchy shit. Round one. That's right, if I can't get the car off the trailer, I'll have to get the trailer from under the car. Same, same, but different. Sketchy shit. Round two. Although to be fair, I'm just trying to straighten the car and the trailer up at this point. Mm-hmm. sketchy shit, round three. Let's not forget it's been well and truly stuffed into a tree, so I can't really harm it anymore, eh? Job done. Well, first job done. Now is the small task of actually getting it up the drive and in the garage. Feel more sketchy shit coming up. Yep, that's right. Let's try and shove it up the drive. What could possibly go wrong? Oh yeah, that. Look, in my defense, I had just driven 20 hours straight through the night, and then just grabbed a couple of hours sleep before attempting this, so maybe my decision-making process wasn't the best at this point. Anyway, such is life. So all I'm doing here is straightening it up. And attempt number two, with a little bit of help, coming right up. So if you can't push, you're gonna have to pull. So after a quick trip to the hardware store, lock and tackle later, off we go. I found out two very important things at this point. One is that the URS4 is fucking heavy. And number two, and more importantly, the pipe bender is bolted to the floor pretty well. So straight into dismantling it, find out what we've actually bought. Well, not exactly straight into it. I did have a couple of days rest before I started attacking it. So first impressions at this point, didn't have any. It was too much shrapnel about to see anything. It all needed removing. Previous owner of this car's watching this, I really hope it's not too hard to watch me butchering the crap out of this, but I will salvage and use as much as I can. I love the seats. Seats are definitely going to go into the Sport Quattro. Of the correct era, chunky, electric, and fantastic condition. I love them. I'm either going to try and use the rears and modify them and get those in the rear of this book Cotro so they all match. As I ran out of light for the day, I also ran out of space in the garage. So all I can do is shuffle the shell across and fit the engine and gearbox down the side. I'm going to have to get rid of this shell before I can split the two and really see what we've got. So that's it for this episode. See you in the next. Cheers.